We now return to Views from the Hill. Once again, here's your host, WBCB News Director, Rick Rickman.
How can you not get fired up from that? Oh my goodness. Thank you, Merrill. All right. On the line, I have a very special guest today. Hello, Stephen.
Hello, and I am fired up by that.
How can you not be? It's great. Thank you to Merrill. So it's so good to have you on the air, Mr. Steve Noll. How are you doing today? You good?
Pleasure to be here. Nice sunny day. I can't complain.
Yeah. For an October day, not much to complain about. But anyway, the reason you're on the air, though, is not to talk about the weather. So I think some people might not know what TMA Bucks is. So help me out. Explain it in a couple of words. What do you do over there?
Okay, well, TMA Bucks is a transportation management association, and the quickest way I can think to explain it to you is we are very much like a chamber of commerce, with the exception that where a chamber of commerce will focus on a variety of issues that confront businesses, we focus entirely on transportation as both a means to grow business, to retain and maintain the business community in Bucks County, and also to reduce congestion from vehicles. All the traffic has to get to those businesses somehow. All the workers have to get to those businesses somehow. So how can we do that, making the most efficient use of our roadway system in the name of cleaner air? So there's an economic standpoint, an economic component, and an environmental component. That, in a nutshell, is what we do at TMA Bucks.
Now, that to me sounds awesome, because like, I mean, yeah, it's like to someone who's stuck in traffic, they're like, great. But from a logistical standpoint, to be able to manage all of the roadways in Bucks County and figure out where's the fastest way to get from point A to point B and what closures are coming up and how do you manage that, there's a lot of thought that goes into that. And I know from personal experience, from putting up news stories about like upcoming closures, people really appreciate that stuff.
No, absolutely, and we're happy to deliver it, and I certainly can't take responsibility for much of that at all. I have a very capable staff that spends a great deal of time researching and broadcasting this information over social media channels and, of course, with the help of outlets such as yours.
Well, always happy to help. Specifically for today, though, one of the big things coming up on the TMA Bucks lineup is the video contest that you have for different, you know, seatbelts or don't text and drive. And I was watching a few of these from last year. This one was uploaded, I think, March of this past year. And it was the Ben Salem High School student one. I don't know if you've seen these videos yourself, but like a lot of them are like really melodramatic. And they're like, oh my God, what do you do when you lose someone? And this kid comes out of left field and he's got Chick-fil-A seatbelt buckled in his passenger seat. I mean, this is genius.
That's absolutely, and the video challenge is just one. It's just one part of the overall student seatbelt use program that we do over the course of the year. It's actually an offshoot from a bigger event that we started called the Bucks County High School Seatbelt Safety Challenge. And the video challenge, I am floored. I have seen them, and I regularly share them with different organizations as I move around Bucks County, just showing what students are capable of. And the technology, I mean, you know, I'm old. I did editing with razor blades and reel-to-reel tape. So just to see the technology that's out there now and the way that the students, even high school age, I mean, this stuff was unheard of in high school until a few years ago. And to see the way they make use of technology and generate these videos, the products are amazing. Now, as far as the video challenge is concerned, you have crazy, you have the ultimate, the subdued, the tug at your heartstrings, because this is a contest.
Yeah.
It's a contest for $500 towards safety programs for your school, and also airtime on local cable systems. the winning PSA will actually receive airtime right among the regular commercial breaks. So these do get shown not just across Bucks County, but across the region as a result of their work. And it ebbs and flows. We get we get years where a lot of them are silly. We get years where a lot of them are serious. We get years with mix. All I'll say is, if you recall the Harlem Shake fad of a few years ago, I really hope nothing like that ever happens again, because I think we got 5 Harlem Shake entries, and but it was still, the point is, it may have been crazy, it may have been stupid, but hey, you got the message.
Yeah, and that's what's important about it. I mean, there's one where it's like a bunch of girls singing Backstreet Boys, I think, I think that's the boy band. And then, like, one of them gets hit by a car by, like, someone who's texting and driving, and it's like, oh my goodness. And then another one where, like I said before, he's got Chick-fil-A seatbelt buckled up in his passenger seat, and him and his friend are screaming in terror as it becomes unbuckled and it goes flying off the seat into the floor of the vehicle. And it's just, it's such a wide spectrum. But the point of it, like you said, is to raise awareness of, like, why wearing a seatbelt is important. I was looking through the most recent press release that Dave Walter set out, and it included a quote from you about how, I think it's gone up by, like, 30 percentage points, this use of a seatbelt throughout Bucks County high schools because of this challenge. That's a huge accomplishment.
It has, and we're really proud of that, actually. When we started this, now to be fair, when we first started this in the fall of 2007, that first year we only had 4 high schools participate. So the first couple of years are a little bit skewed, but we had almost countywide participation within the first 5 years, and this is the second year that we've had all 20 of the eligible public and private high schools across Bucks County competing against each other in this challenge. And when we started this back in 2007, the concern was that seatbelt use among high school age drivers, 16 and passengers, about 16 to 18 years old, was considerably lower than the overall average across Bucks County. So we wanted to target the younger drivers and to raise that level of seatbelt usage. When we started this in 2007, the goal was to achieve 90% usage of seatbelts among high school age drivers. Not only did we achieve that goal in the ensuing years, but now in the past couple of years, when we do the fall unannounced fall baseline surveys at the high schools across Bucks County, the average use across the county has been 90%. So we're starting now at or above the goal that we had hoped to achieve when we started this 13 years ago.
Yeah, that's crazy to think about the success that you've brought. I mean, like, obviously, you know, it's a pat on the back, and you get to say, like, hey, you know, we all did this great thing over at TMA Bucks, but, like, this is lives, you know? These are people who are going to be alive after an accident because of an initiative that you are all working on, and that's pretty incredible. Even the stories, like, you know, as hard as I might work over here at WBCB, I don't think I'm saving lives. So that's a pretty big deal.
It's humbling to think about at times. One of the favorite questions that I get asked is, well, how many lives has this program saved? And well, I stare blankly for a second and go, how am I supposed to know that?
How is that even possible to know?
But some people still ask me, and I said, when's the last time you saw a headline, you know, 16-year-old not killed in car accident? But what you do see, and I mean, of course you have no way of knowing what the outcome would have been otherwise, and frankly I don't care what the outcome would have been otherwise, you do see articles in the news and reports on the news where everyone in the car was wearing a seatbelt and everyone in the car walked away.
Yeah.
And that at the end of the day, until we get 100%, we're not there. There's still some people that, for reasons I couldn't begin to imagine, aren't putting on a seatbelt.
Well, it's kind of like I see it the same as kind of like smoking. Like, some people you're just not going to convince, and it seems to be that way for some reason. I don't know why.
It, It's very true, and I guess some people just don't want to change their habits, and some people are unmovable. But the fact that we have, just looking at the results briefly, the spring follow-up surveys that are conducted after the schools are alerted of their fall baseline numbers and after the student groups utilize peer pressure to attempt to increase seatbelt usage, I'm looking from the 12th annual challenge that concluded earlier this year. We've had, I'm seeing a lot of, just running down the list here, 96%, 93%, winning high school, 97%.
Yeah.
95%, and nothing lower than the high 80s, which is really quite amazing. And the countywide average use was 93%.
It's fantastic. For people who aren't convinced, there was a story back in this past June. It's the only one I can think of in recent memory within the past few years of an instance where people were ejected from a vehicle, and it was over in Bristol Township, and it was an 18-year-old woman who clearly would have been high school age, and a 19-year-old woman, or at max a freshman in college. This is the age demographic that this whole campaign is targeting, and that's the point. And unfortunately, the woman passed away, because that's what happens when you get ejected from a car. It's really just tragic, but at the same time, I think it reinforces the point that this is a pretty good mission.
Well, if I asked any reasonable person to go out into the parking lot of the building they're in right now and smack their face into the windshield, I don't think any of them would do it.
Well, you might get a couple of takers.
Well, possibly. I mean, I think there's whole television shows based around that concept. But anyway, the most reasonable people wouldn't go out and smack their head against the windshield. And you got to keep in mind, that's only probably at 10 or 15 miles an hour. You're hitting a windshield at even a speed as slow as 30 or 35 miles an hour, that would definitely get your attention, and actually probably far worse than get your attention, as is the case in so many of these unfortunate crashes where someone is considerably injured or doesn't survive.
Yeah. Well, it's good work that you're doing. And so I'm a student, right? How can I get engaged?
Well, the clubs in the schools that we actually work with various clubs, and it can be any club from the key, we have key clubs, SAD groups. We actually had in one school one year the choir actually was the club that decided with their faculty liaison or advisor to take this challenge on. Hmm. And that group will then utilize any peer pressure methods that it wants to encourage students to wear a seatbelt. Couple that stick out in my mind was a year when students would stand at the exits of the schools as the students were driving out for the day, and if you didn't, if you were wearing your seatbelt, they gave you a dum-dum lollipop through the window and said, thanks for not being a dum-dum. little things, just things like that get the message across. And you can tell, we have a group of trained volunteers that conduct these counts now. But in the very early days, I used to do it myself. And even in those early days, you would have students that they were on to you. They if you couldn't stay out of sight, they knew what you were doing, and they'd be flapping their shoulder belts at you, waving out the windows, saying, "Yep, look at me, I'm wearing mine." Clearly the message gets out there, and a lot of students will utilize morning announcements. So many schools now do video morning announcements,
yeah,
which is another concept completely foreign to the likes of me.
We had those in kindergarten. That's going back 20 years. Holy cow.
Yep. They'll use the video the video morning announcements to actually do. They'll either show sometimes they'll show the video entry if they have it. Sometimes they will just talk about the challenge and why it's important to wear your seatbelt. And this is entirely student driven. Once we give them the number, we are available at the TMA to work with them as need be. But we don't tell them what to do or how to do it. This is completely student driven.
Awesome.
And that's the most impressive thing about this is students helping students, and the results are showing in the numbers that come back on these papers every year.
Cool. All right. Well, Steven, I want to keep talking to you, and I'll probably have you on in the future. But right now, I got to say au revoir and wish you a good afternoon. Thank you so much for coming on.
My pleasure, Rick. Thank you.
All right. Steven Noll with TMA Bucks, doing a great job over there. We'll be right back after these words.